Hi, and welcome to this YouTube channel. If you're new here, hey, how's it going? If you're subscribed and you're returning, hey, how's it going? Good to see you back. You see, you're getting this bonus greeting if you're subscribed. So make sure to subscribe to receive this bonus greeting. Now that we're done with the most original intro that I haven't seen anywhere else do it, we're going to jump into the video. And today I'm going to tell you about none other but the most requested story of the past year. It's not. Talent shows. I get this comment a lot. Hey, you should go on the talent show. You should go on America's Got Talent. Or you should go on X Factor or Idol. And no. There are multiple reasons why that is not a good idea. And if I try to mention all of those reasons in this particular video, it's gonna be too long of the video and you're gonna get bored and click away. So we're just gonna focus on a few aspects that I was able to gather through my own experience. So let's travel back in time. The year was 2009, nearly 30 years ago or so, depending when are you watching this video. The location was Lithuania. If you look at this map, here is Lithuania. I was playing music for about 2 years and I was trying to figure out how to get on MTV. There was no MTV in Lithuania. Nevertheless, Lithuania had 6 TV channels, with 2 of them actually being relevant. And one of the TV channels announced that they're gonna start a TV show, very original, called Lithuania's Got Talent. Never done before in Lithuania, first time such thing. Apparently they bought the license from Britain's Got Talent. I think Got Talent concept originated in Britain. I don't know who exactly started it, nor do I care to know. The network who had the rights to do Lithuania's Got Talent was called TV3. Which on most channels in Lithuania, you grab your remote and after you turn on your television, you click number 3 out of 6. And that was number 3 channel. So, like I said, I was playing music for about 2 years and I was looking to take my career to the next level. I was ready for, I don't know, a Grammy, maybe a BAFTA award, anything that would bring me more credibility to my amazing musical ability and playing. One of those nights I was sitting on the couch and looking at television while practicing my guitar, and the commercial comes on. Hey, do you have talent? To be honest, I don't remember what exactly it said, but it said go to this website and register. So I did. You put in your name, your age, what's your favorite color, what ice cream do you like? Probably you don't put in those, but you fill out a questionnaire. And then later on, you get an email back a few months later or so saying that come to the auditions in person or please don't come. It was a complete and total mayhem about 2 months later after they announced the registry on the web, because nearly everybody got told, hey, come to live auditions. I remember there were lines of, I don't know, hundreds and hundreds of people. We drove 3 hours to a different city to attend an audition. And it was, my heart was pounding so hard, it was about to fall out of my chest. I've done high school talent shows before, and a shaky camera footage from those exist to this day, but I've never done anything on the scale of national television. So we're gonna dive in a little bit today to explore that particular experience. We're gonna try to figure out what I learned from it, what could have been better, and how we can apply this knowledge today. So let's just jump into it. It was incredibly hard to find remaining footage because, like I said earlier, it was over 30 years ago in 2009. So let's try to see what surviving evidence exists on the internet.
Pirmąją gitarą dovanų Dovydas gavo prieš 4 metus.
Radau savo sferą, savo nišą, kur galiu save realizuoti ir man tai labai patinka.
I look the same. I haven't changed one bit.
Namuose įkurtoje įrašų studijoje ne tik 6 gitaros, būgnų komplektas ir lūpinės armonikėlės. Čia repetuoja ir Dovydo draugai.
Vasarą atsidarydavau langus ir erzindavau kaimynus, garsiai grodavau būgnais.
Okay, I wasn't able to find the audition footage, but here we are. This was before the semifinals. So what they do in those particular talent shows, I don't think it even should be called Lithuania's Got Talent or Got Talent of any country. Think of it more as you laugh, you lose kind of thing. But even change the title to You React, We Win. By we, the television network, by you, meaning the viewer. The concept is simple, very similar to Luai or You Laugh, You Lose. You bring out the memes, you react to them, and hopefully people will continue watching the video to the point where you can extend it to be over 10 minutes so you can insert a mid-roll ad. Same concept, but instead of memes, you have people willingly signing their nearly life away for a shot to be displayed on national television. And instead of a charismatic host, you have 3 judges. Nearly everything is scripted.
When since my baby left me, jaunasis bluzo karalius Dovydas.
We're gonna get back to this part. The actual auditions, the first auditions were actually in front of the producers and not the actual judges. And once they decided who they're gonna display on television, they said, please come back a few months later, but please wear the same clothes you wore when you were auditioning in person for the producers. So in the edit, they can make it seem when you see the line outside and then they show the theater full of people with the judges in there. Actually, those 2 segments usually are a few months apart, but they're making it seem like it was in the same day.
Labas vakaras.
Labas vakaras. Kuris esate, kuris?
A koks jums skirtumas? Aš Romantė Dmitrijus. Čia mano brolis.
Ar jūs vilniečiai?
Jo, mes vilniečiai.
Aišku, gerai. Tai jūs šį vakarą mums parodysite?
Aš ne tik dainininkas, bet ir poetas. Davai, skaityk savo eilėraštį. Kada aš išmoksiu lietuvių kalbą, man bus nereikalinga vertėjo pagalba. Aš sukursiu krūvą.
This is a stand-up comedian. We have stand-up comedians in Lithuania.
Labas vakaras.
Labas vakaras, Marijonai.
Ko jūs vardu leisite paklausti?
Aš esu ponia Jadija. Jadija esu. Jas Marija, koks gražus vardas.
O Jadija, jūs iš kur atvykot?
Šiaip.
Now, most talent shows, they follow the same model when it comes to judges. There is there's like a middle-aged younger guy, somewhat semi-shaved beard, maybe a little bit gray hair, and he's like the bad guy. And there is like an older guy, sort of like a grandpa figure. And in the middle, there's a mother figure to sort of balance everything out. So this particular reiteration of talent show in Lithuania was no different. When you signed a contract with a talent show, they can do a lot of things and you can do very little. Your name and image becomes a trademark they can use and misrepresent. Wasn't there anybody to tell these people that you're not funny or you're not good? Well, the way it works, they invite everybody to the audition and the producers are evaluating. And if it's really weird and if it's really bizarre, let's say like you're singing and it's kind of bad and it's, you know, you cringe, you lose. That type of aspect is being used when they're profiling you for a potential candidacy to be on the show, they will hype you up, the producers, before you go in front of the judges. They will tell you, you are very good. You'll say, really? Yes, we would love to have you. What other song do you know? Oh, I can sing Celine Dion. I will go on. And then, okay, do it. And it's really bad. And then they tell you it was absolutely great. Such and such judge will absolutely love it. So they hype you up, and these people, hyped up by the producers of the show because they were convinced, they go on with even more confidence, and then they perform. And let's say you say something and for the judges. You say to the judges, hey, actually, the producers told me I was really good. Well, guess what? They're gonna edit that out. My actual dialogue where I was talking in the first audition in front of the judges in the theater in real time took about 10 minutes. They edited it down to about 1 minute. Let me show you something. You can already see a setup, maybe before a commercial break. Music. Dead giveaway. Like, straight up comedy.
Labas vakaras.
Labas vakaras. Kuo vardu?
Vytautas.
Iš kur?
Iš Marijampolės.
Kiek jums metų?
17.
Koks jūsų talentas?
Dainavimas.
Ką dainuosite?
Savo kūrybos dainą.
Seniai rašote dainas?
Gal ne, tai kokia.
Gerai, paklausykim.
This whole segment took 22 seconds, and you can hear the cutoff in the edit.
Gal ne, tai kokia.
Gerai, paklausykim.
Where the claps show up out of nowhere. Pretty sure there was more to the exchange than just that.
Gal ne, tai kokia.
Gerai, paklausykim.
Right there.
Kaip pasakyti myliu, kai tu taip toli, tu taip toli. Aš noriu būti šalia, jaust rankas tas. Aš noriu Nesvarbu, kur būsi tu, ar už marių, ar už jūrų tolių.
Kiprai labai silpnai.
Da-da-da-da-da-da. He's clearly nervous. He's holding a microphone. Now everybody's laughing. Out of the way, he's holding the microphone. Okay, so if these are funny talents, which talents are, like, not funny? Which talents are... Well, I don't know. They removed a lot of 2009 clips, okay? I'm not gonna present myself as the alternative to all of this, because maybe in somebody else's eyes is just as bad. What was really difficult to find was the actual winner. So I made it to the finals. I couldn't find the clip for you to show where I'm in the finals because probably they deleted it. I know that this is the semi-finals where I'm doing the early version of a live looping performance, but this is the analog version. Well, I play a little bit of guitar, then I play a little bit of bass, then I play a little bit of keyboard, and I play a little bit of harmonica, and I play drums, and finish with drums and singing. I can't look at this seriously. Long story short, who wins the Lithuania's Got Talent? He's a cool dude.
Lietuvos talentų dalyvius atrankų metu kikenti privertė vaikinas, nuolat krapštantis dantis.
Well, I don't have patience to watch this, but...
Thank you.
that was the winner of Lithuania's Got Talent 2009. I got into an argument with producers, so I placed last in the finals because they wanted me to wear a red chicken style Elvis suit, and I said I wouldn't wear it. There's more to the story. I'm barely glossing over multiple details here. There's a lot, and if you'd like me to elaborate a little bit more, maybe I can make a separate video about talent shows in general, because I've auditioned after that. I did another talent show in Lithuania. I've auditioned for Britain's Got Talent, Germany's Got Talent, Germany's X Factor, and I think that was about... Oh, and Eurovision in Lithuania. Here's quick things you should know about talent shows. The producers are not going to tell you the truth. Most of the events you're seeing on television are totally scripted. Stories are exaggerated, embellished. When you sign a contract, you're also signing away many things, including your usage of social media, especially in the latest reiterations of the newer contracts. For example, when I was signing a contract for Britain's Got Talent, even before I made it to the audition, it said that they own the rights to use your image on all technologies current and the ones that will be invented in the future, Britain, as well as the rest of the universe. They used the word "the rest" in the rest of the universe. So I thought that was pretty comical. There is a reason why none of your favorite American Idol contestants, even the ones that completed the show 2-3 years ago, don't have their own YouTube channels or don't vlog. Even the current contestants on these talent shows, that would make you think great content. Hey, I'm here with Christina Aguilera. She's my vocal coach here on X Factor. It's just a quick vlog. Well, they're not allowed. And even, let's say, if they only made as far to the semifinals, they get kicked out of the show. They still can't do anything for, I don't know, 3 or 5 years. I know personally some former contestants on some talent shows in US and in Europe where they only made it to the semifinals and they're no longer on the show and they still can't perform live or make videos or record their music or release their music because their name, their face is owned by the network that owns the rights to that particular talent show. Luckily, in Lithuania, it was the first season of Lithuania's Got Talent, so they didn't really know what they were doing with the contracts. It was loosely written and expired pretty quickly, so I was able to do whatever I wanted. And if I wasn't able to do whatever I wanted, I did it anyways. And then I just left Lithuania. This is one of those comments that I get a lot. Hey, you should go on America's Got Talent. Hey, you should go on American Idol or whatever. And I appreciate the sentiment, because when people usually say that, they don't know the intricacies of those particular TV shows, and they simply mean well. They saw the video, maybe they liked what I did in the video, and they're wishing me well, and maybe they're wishing me to do even better than I'm currently doing. So in their understanding, going on a TV talent show would elevate the career to the next level. It sort of would, but at the same time, the YouTube channel would become corporately owned, and I wouldn't even be able to take a fart on Snapchat without the network's approval. Let me know if there are any particular topics you'd like me to expand upon, give you more details. Thank you for watching. Make sure to subscribe and click the bell. I'm posting 3 times a week. Which I think is a pretty good number. And leave a comment below what topic you'd like me to expand upon more. And maybe I can make some useful advice for musicians who are starting out or performers who are starting out that are considering on going on these particular TV shows. Because in my opinion, you don't need to. There is YouTube. Bye-bye.